There are concerns tonight that our borders reopening might not bring the tourism boom we so desperately need. While our cases are coming down, there are fears the world still sees us as too high risk, meaning the hope for a flood of visitors may just be a trickle.
Up top, down under, views for miles. But today, the cocktail bar in Sydney Tower is closed with no international tourists. They're only open 5 days out of seven.
It's a jewel in a crown that no one gets to see. So absolutely, it's a missed opportunity.
But when the borders open in 2 weeks, they're expecting a trickle, not a surge.
Is it something that we look forward to tomorrow? That's a bit too optimistic, I think.
While one travel website saw a 23% spike in searches for Australia.
So the top inbound countries are the UK, India, US, Korea and Ireland.
Our biggest market for tourists, China, is still forcing its citizens into hotel quarantine when they get home.
Scenic World used to have 220,000 Chinese visitors a year, which is a huge number for any attraction in Australia, and we're not expecting them back even within that 12-month timeframe.
And airlines are yet to add extra flights. Filling a plane usually takes months. The border opens in a fortnight. Still, the Premier is offering open arms atop the bridge without a harness.
It wasn't like I jumped a fence and ran up the Harbour Bridge.
A city open for business, border restrictions finally disappearing. But what tourism operators say we need to do now is to send a message to the world that Fortress Australia won't be lifting its drawbridge up again anytime soon.
You have to get the advertising campaigns and everything else as well flowing.
Businesses like Scenic World do not have marketing dollars behind them anymore. We're spending all our money on maintenance.
Questions too about the return of cruise ships. The current ban expires in 9 days.
Well, if we're allowed to fly overseas and be in a metal tube for 24 hours, there's no reason why we can't have, three nights and 2 days on a cruise ship.
Mark Trevorrow performed for years on comedy cruises as his alter ego Bob Down.
Can you imagine? He's got his whole cruising outfit. He's got his cravat. He's got his open neck shirt. He's got his sailor's hat. He's got his captain's hat. Oh, he's furious.
Well, this is kind of cart before the horse. We're waiting for the federal government.
The Premier also revealing whether school COVID testing will continue beyond the current 4-week scheme.
Unlikely.
Instead, his chief health officer is begging.
Parents, please go out and get your children vaccinated.
Daniel Sutton for 10 News First.